keep in mind that any time that there is bleeding or bruising going on in the brain, that means that usually there is accompanying damage to the nerve cells in that area. Not only do the blood itself become the problem as it collects and pushes on the surrounding nerve tissues, it can also then increase the pressure inside the skull. Because the skull has only a limited amount of space within it, when the pressure rises inside the skull, the brain becomes squished. And it's so soft that it will tend to try to squeeze through whatever opening it has. And in the human brain, unfortunately, the only opening is this big hole at the bottom where the brainstem goes through and connects with the spinal cord. If you try to imagine this whole brain trying to squeeze through a little hole like that, you can see how that would not work. This is what happens when people die rapidly in a brain injury situation. It's often because the pressure has risen so much that the brain has tried to squeeze through that hole, and then the brainstem gets choked off and you lose level of consciousness and eventually die. When the brain is squeezing through areas that it shouldn't, this is called herniation. And this is a situation where then the neurosurgeons will have to often operate in order to relieve the pressure, to relieve the herniation or prevent it from happening. So brain injury really consists of not only the initial insult, be it a direct force, acceleration, deceleration, or lack of oxygen, but it can also result from the sequelae of that within the next few minutes to hours, from the blood collecting, the increase in the pressure in the skull, and sometimes from the ventricles also enlarging. So those are the ways that your brain is injured in the acute period. Some people who have brain tumors also experience similar injuries, even though a tumor might be growing more slowly. But eventually, it occupies enough space that it can cause a rise in the intracranial pressure, or it starts to push on enough structures that the neurons can no longer survive. So those are the common ways in which a brain injury occurs.